Hey there, welcome to Talk Plus. So we have just finished our little mini three-part series all about the vision of Ashford Vineyard. So who we are, what we're like, and then this week I spoke about what we do. Now that is focused around our aims, like why are we here in Ashford? And we looked at John 10:10, where Jesus says, "I have come that they may have life and have it abundantly or till it overflows." And that is the mandate that God has placed on this family as Ashford Vineyard, is to be here in Ashford and to bring life. And if we aren't gonna do that, then what's the point of us being here? Like, what's gonna set us apart from any other kind of charity or kind of project in Ashford that is doing wonderful things? So I would love to encourage you. I'd actually like to read out the quote again that I used on Sunday, just by way of helping to focus a little bit of your discussion now. So this quote I mentioned is from a guy called Paul Manwaring, who we've been spending a lot of time with, like online, but listening to him, his teaching, and working through some stuff. And he says this: "We live in the days of the greatest opportunity and the greatest change. What a privilege that is. We are sons and daughters of the King, and his kingdom is ever increasing. Leading, managing, stewarding the opportunity and change will inspire every aspect of our lives. This is our time. This is our moment. Let's not waste it. Let's take hold of this moment and our gifts and look to see what impact we can have on the earth." And one of the things I said on Sundays is that we're not an institution. We're not interested in like pulling people in to do stuff just for the sake of it. This is about equipping and seeing the whole of the church equipped and released to bring life where they are. And so I just wanted to kind of use that quote as a bit of a conversation starter for you guys in your group, to ask you to think about what your gifts are, what you love doing, like where are you right now? Where's God leading you? What kind of moments and spaces are you in where the invitation of God is to step out and bring life, to step out more and bring life, to be courageous in holding spaces and moments with your co-workers, with your neighbours, with your families? And I don't know if, just before I finish, I don't know if you guys have got one of these. I've hole punched mine because I keep it in a folder. But if you don't have one of these have got our aims on them. And so I just really encourage you, if you haven't got one of them, you can get one of them from the warehouse. They are in the reception area. So please do grab one, stick it up in your fridge, shove it in your Bible. These are our aims. They're what we do together as a family. But actually, these aims are nothing new. They're nothing original. These are just all the things that we see Jesus doing. And we see Jesus did when he lived on the earth. And actually, so we see these as key to who God's called us to be as followers of Jesus. So we're leaning hard into these. I just really encourage you, think about what are your gifts? What are the moments and the spaces in which you are in? And what's the invitation of God in those spaces, in those moments, to bring life? Because you are kingdom bearing sons and daughters of the living God, and he's inviting us all into an incredible adventure to keep leaning in and growing into bringing his light life, as the Message translation says. So I hope you have a really great conversation and that it stirs up some stuff for you, and maybe like give yourself a challenge, like give yourselves a challenge, like how are you guys going to take a next step in growing into bringing life and taking courage. So yeah, have fun. Bye.